like these two ducks, your aperture and the shutter speed on your camera are actually in a relationship. It's called reciprocity. They're in a reciprocal relationship. Whatever you do to one, you've got to do to the other in order to maintain your exposure. Now, I know I'm making your head hurt, but look, let me show you. Back at the office, I've set the camera up so it's looking at a monitor. That way we know it's a constant light source. Nothing's going to change. Right now, the camera tells me that the correct exposure for that monitor is a 90th of a second with an aperture of f8. Suppose I wanted to change that aperture. I'm going to change it to, let's go to f16. Straight away, you can see the light meter says it's underexposed. We've made that aperture, that hole, smaller. So we have to make the time the shutter is open for longer to compensate. So as I dial in a slower shutter speed, we're now at a 20th and the light meter has come all the way back. It's the same the other way round. If I was to think, right, I want to use a faster shutter speed, let's go all the way up here to, let's say, 125th, that shutter's not open for as long. So therefore the aperture would have to be bigger to let more light in. It's a reciprocal arrangement. Change the aperture, let's make it bigger. Here we go, it's at f6.7 and the light meter's gone back into the middle. So why would I want to change my aperture or shutter speed? Well, there are creative reasons. I may want to use a fast shutter speed to freeze motion, such as a racing car or somebody running. I may want to use a wide aperture because that will blur the background in a picture. Now there's a couple of handy things on the camera which will do a lot of this work for you. For example, if I go into Aperture Priority, also called AV, Aperture Value on some cameras, it lets me set an aperture, whatever I choose it to be, so I can get whatever depth of field I want, and the camera will go off and find me a shutter speed to work with it. If I put it into Shutter Priority, also known as TV or Time Value, I'm going to go and find a shutter speed that I want to use. Could be fast, could be slow. The camera will then go off and find the appropriate aperture to work with it.